A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not enter into a sanctuary made by hands, a copy of the true one, but heaven itself, that he might now appear before God on our behalf, that he might offer himself repeatedly as the high priest enter each year into the sanctuary with blood that is not his own. If that was so, he would have had to suffer immediately from the foundation of the world. But now, once for all, he has appeared at the end of ages to take away the sin by his sacrifice. Just as the appointed that human being died once, and after this judgment, also Christ, offered once to take away the sin of many, will appear a second time, not to take away the sin, but to bring salvation to those who eagerly await it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The letter of the Hebrews again reminds us who is Jesus Christ. He is the eternal Son of God, that although we enter in history, in our world as human, he is not made by hand. In other words, he is not one of us. Because although he became one of us in the flesh, from all eternity he was God. And that's why he is at the right hand of God intercede for us, because he is God. Then he said to us that he himself offered himself once and for all. Not like the priest of the Old Testament, that once a year they take the blood of the bulls and the lambs, and they go behind the sanctuary, and they sprinkle over the Ark of the Covenant and then on the people, to wipe away the sins of the people. Jesus did it once for all. Because although he became human, he is a divine person. And that's why he said, as all of us have to die, because this is the call of each one of us, that we will come into life, we have to end this life. This life is a transfer, this life is a transfer to eternity. And after we die, we are going to face judgment. And that's why he said to us here, Christ is not going to come a second time as we profess to come. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. Not to die again. He comes to take with him those who in this life are awaiting him with eagerness. And that is a very important message. Because as we are going to see this coming Sunday, if we are going to be attached to sin, then we are not really in God. But if we are going to be separate from sin, separate ourselves from sin, then our life is pleasing to God. And this life, with all the sacrifices, with all the sometimes the upsetness that we go through, all the disappointments we go through, is a rehearsal to prepare us for that great day when Jesus will come again to take us home. I am not going to leave you orphans. I am going to prepare a place for you. And then I will come back to take you to myself. So where I am, you also may be. That's what the author is trying to say. That if we are waiting for him in eagerness, then yes, that sacrifice that he himself the Father gave him to do on the hill of Calvary, when we, each one of us, immerse ourselves in the waters of baptism, in that passion and death of Christ, we now have the pledge that that death has wiped away our sin, gave us again our status as sons and daughters, and so we have the earth, the inheritance promised to us. Because now we become heirs of the kingdom, because we are children of God, and we will do good. We we hear His voice, every one of us, whether in the tomb or wherever we are, we will go, we will stand, we will wake up, and wake up with Him. Unfortunately, some are going to wake up for their condemnation, and some are going to wake up for their glorification. And that's why the last sentence there of two lines are very powerful. For those who wait, await,